team. Well, baby, don't get down, don't you worry about a thing, 'cause the way you fill them out, hey, that's all right with me. I don't want the girl you used to be. And if you ain't noticed, the kids are fast asleep and you're one hot mama. You turn me on, let's turn it up and turn this room into a sauna. One hot mama. Oh, what do you say?
And gentlemen, boys and girls, children, friends, and bikers of all ages, this is your BCW Chaos Bikers Gone Wild main event. Introducing first, standing in the corner to my right, from Belfast, Northern Ireland, weighing 125 pounds, Emma Gray. And your opponent, standing in the corner to my left. She stands 5'9" tall. And if anyone asks about her weight, I'll kick your ass. From right here, can't put your bitch in, Mama T! Yay! And your referee in charge is Nicole Brashear.
Alrighty then. Now with that all out of the way,
our main event is underway.
Yeah, pretty much. I won't be surprised if this becomes at some point a cat fight.
Now this could very well become a cat fight.
Meow. And I'm not saying that just because I'm a cat.
Oh, I'm pretty sure you're saying it just because you're a cat. You're still mad that Avenged Nirvana actually won. Anyways, side headlock here for Emma Gray. What a drop kick!
Right into the head.
Oh, Emma Gray said we're gonna ignore the body, go right to the head here. Mama T off the ropes. She went to those ropes backwards.
Ooh!
Oh, that discus elbow, that Judas. And I hear someone yaying an Eldritch Horror.
What?
You probably don't get the reference, do you?
Probably not at the moment.
Yeah, Mama T, those knee strikes right to the thigh, and then an elbow right to the knee of Emma Gray, taking out the power game.
Ooh.
And this crowd is loving this match right now.
Every single minute of it.
Hey, how do you not? Oh, here we go.
Do you think she? Yep.
Yep, she's going to remind her to mind her damn manners.
Well, she better.
No. She only got a one count out of that? All right.
But hey, it was only at some point where she was going to tell her to mind her manners. Because you don't dare ever piss off Mama T.
And Mama T, those knees to the face. Scorpion kick. Hello!
Ooh! A one. Two. No.
Not gonna happen this time.
But it was worth a shot.
Was indeed worth a shot here.
Oh gosh, here we go with the cross.
Well, it happened. And damn.
Oh boy.
Elbow drop. Looked like it went almost to her face. Anarchy out here just telling Mama T to hurt Emma Gray. But look at this.
Oh.
Jawbreaker by Emma Gray.
I think the one who's getting hurt right now is Mama T.
I hear a lot of booing here now for Emma Gray. Holy crap.
That's not something that we hear often when it comes to Emma Gray.
Well, look where we are, and look who's from here.
Very true, you have a point.
Yep, look where we are, and look who's in the ring right now.
I mean, yeah, it's kind of a given.
Yep, looks like we got a very, very partial crowd to Mama T here.
Mm-hmm. Oh boy.
They are not liking what Emma Gray is doing right now.
Not one little bit. Oh!
Ouch. And then that's gonna give her a pin.
One, a two.
No. A two.
No three.
Nope. Oh, what a neck breaker, though. Gotta give it to Emma for that.
Well, yeah, she did really good on that. We can never, ever take that away from her.
But, ooh, Emma Gray gonna go to the top rope here.
Oh, boy. She's gonna be flying. Whee! Boom!
And then another pin.
One, two... Nope.
Mama kicks out of it.
Oh boy. I would say that she's getting a run for her money, but she's getting a run for something, all right.
And oh!
Uh-oh. Oh, she's getting twisted up.
Mama T is on pretzel right now.
Indeed. Oof.
Oh. And Anarchy telling Mama to not tap out.
Well, with the kind of pain Anarchy that she's experiencing, I won't be surprised if she does.
And Anarchy threatening if Mama T taps out, she'll do far worse.
Uh-oh. She is trying so hard to reach the ropes.
Matisse still is far away from... Oh, there she goes, the drag.
Oh, she's got the ropes.
Yep. And so Emma Gray has to let this go.
Reluctantly.
The shooter is broken.
Ooh, you can see that Emma's literally staring daggers at Anarchy right now.
I'm pretty sure at some point every lady in the back's gonna wanna get in there and just take Anarchy out.
And frankly, I wouldn't blame them one little bit on it. Uh-oh.
What in the world? Where did Mama learn how to do that?
Two. Oh. I don't know, but it worked for her.
Where in the world did Mama learn how to do that?
I can only assume it's from one person and one person only.
That'd be Anarchy that taught her.
Exactly. But this is only just a hunch.
Well, Emma Gray has been thrown into the corner.
One place you never, ever want to try and get yourself into. Well, depending on the situation.
No, definitely not.
Uh-oh.
And then...
Ow.
Mama's just gonna come and smash Emma Gray's head right into that turnbuckle.
That's gotta hurt. Oh!
Now just gonna go knee to right and... Oof. Drive the wind out of Emma Gray here.
Oh, indeed.
And then a corner hip attack.
Oh my god. Uh-oh. She's got her by the foot.
That's not very fruity.
Sadly, no.
Otherwise, we're talking about fruit by the foot.
Indeed, but sadly we aren't.
Not, but now I'm thinking about having it later. Either way. Too bad I ain't sharing with you.
I didn't ask for any. Besides, I got peanut butter M&Ms for later.
Yum. Emma Gray is curled up on the ground here, has not moved.
Mm-mm.
Mama T off the ropes.
Oh no.
Handstand leg drop!
Oh, my goodness. Ooh.
And Anarchy is telling Mama T to stop showing off and just end it.
Maybe she likes to show off. Oh, boy. Yeah.
Emma comes off the ropes now.
Ooh.
What an enziguri.
Indeed. Oof. I mean, meow.
Jeez, this crowd is loud, Trixie.
No kidding.
It's like the loudest crowd we've had.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, you have to think. They have a reason to be loud.
Well, Emma Gray now in control here. She better not take too long.
Yeah, because that could come back and bite her hard. And she wouldn't want that.
Well, who knows when Mama T is going to decide to want to break a bitch.
Well, just give her the time and she'll do it. Oh, no.
Over the top rope, out onto the floor, out into this, I guess, sand.
Well, she's on the padding part of it. If you want to call it padding.
Padding.
Yeah, this is...
Yeah, these fans are just...
They are just ruthless.
They are ruthless tonight, my god. Comes up a great Torpicon Elo!
Oof.
Takes out both Anarchy and Mama T. And herself.
Oh boy.
That's not gonna make Anarchy.
My thoughts exactly, Ref. My thoughts exactly.
On this one, yeah, I have to agree.
Because I don't think anyone wants this to be a double count out.
No, I certainly don't want this to be a double count out. We already had a count out tonight.
Yeah, no. Mm-mm.
Yeah, we're still trying to figure out what happened to Lucardi Black, the real deal, LBA, whatever you want to call him.
Yeah, just hopefully don't call we him figure that out. We hopefully figure that out soon.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, Trixie is late for dinner. Dinner with the Trench Brothers.
I don't know where the boom was at, you or just what's going on in the ring. But I won't be surprised if it's a mixture of both.
I don't know.
One, two...
Emma Gray just getting booed as she pins Mama T.
Nope.
Oh, damn!
Sheesh.
You guys are vicious tonight.
Well, sometimes they need to be. You gotta get a point across in some fashion.
Yeah, they're trying to warm up a team back into this match. And hello! Just fury punches, now whips Emma Gray into the ropes. Takes her off the ropes.
Ooh.
And Mama T gets a clothesline, using Emma Gray's momentum to break her.
Indeed.
Damn near takes her head off.
Luckily it didn't. Yeah, that would be a bit of a messy situation.
A bit of a messy situation?
Yeah.
There's this neat little thing, Trixie. We used to have it. It was a fun. Skulls for Anarchy.
Oh, come on. Oh.
Man, Mama D telling. Have a great respect to Elder.
Well, you best better do that. Or else, who knows what would happen if she were to dare disrespect her elders.
Yeah, she might order ahead. Somebody
Ooh.
Might order ahead to come off.
Possibly.
And Emma Gray gritting her teeth coming into the middle of the ring. Mama T wrist lock after the lockup.
Oh boy.
Now strike right to the small of the back.
This is not good.
Hey, that's an arm bar, it looks like.
It's hard for me to tell if it's an arm bar or if she's trying to have her go nighty-night.
It's an arm bar, Trixie.
Well, from a certain angle, it's hard to tell.
Yeah, from a certain angle, it looks like a leg is over the throat. And it was.
Oh, wait.
Roll up, roll up!
One, two, no!
Oh, good!
That would have been one hell of a disappointment right there.
And a super kick as soon as Mama T got to her feet.
Indeed.
Wait a minute. Referee checking on Mama T.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Well, that was... Referee never caught it.
I am no happy kitty right now.
You can get angry and happy in the same damn panties, Trixie. Okay, you can get happy and angry and happy without wearing panties. How about that? It's cold underwear, kids. Anyways, we're back to Mama T having a foot.
And, ooh!
Kicking a leg.
Yeah, that wouldn't be pleasant at all.
No, that would be like, that would be that guy in SpongeBob that always says, "Bug!"
Yes. Oh!
Mama T code red!
One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this match by pinfall, Mama T!
And I don't know about you, but that was a pretty close-knit match there.
It was, but I don't think we're done tonight.
Oh?
Match is over. And we can just push Mama T out of the way and throw kick and cord kick Emma Gray. What the hell?
Ow.
And we gotta get the medic out here for Emma Gray. She might be seriously hurt.
Yeah, we really should see her doing that.
Somebody. Oh, thank goodness Emma Gray is on her feet under her own power.
Oh, Lord.
With the help of the ropes. And you got kicked pretty hard there, Emma. You sure you don't need a doctor? Call the ambulance.
Wow.
I didn't say anything about a ambulance.
Just medical attention. Nothing more.
Yeah, we don't need to go to the hospital for this.
You know, John, we can't seem to start a show for weeks now without somebody walking out here right away. and deciding they had to have words with us, had we?
Okay, so here we are a week before WrestleFest 15, an event where history will be made, and I want to thank you for all your kind words. Your faith and your devotion haven't gone unnoticed. All of you have been extolling the magnitude of DCWF return, and this, my friends, is where and when more than ever we will need you most. This event, the impact that this year WrestleFest will have in this community, will be undeniable, shaking the very true foundation of SL Pro Wrestling community. The excitement for what has to come has been palpable during the past weeks, and for that reason I would like if both Mama T and Leah Duffield would join me here, and I'm sure they also will like spend a few words.
Well, it sounds like she wants to have words not only with DCWF fans but also Mama T and Leah. Oh, and here comes Liga Dufel.
Even in this change you can stop me. Even in this change you can stop me. Even in this change you can stop me.
Okay. When I was 12 years old, a friend of the family, Harley 13 Tiger Prob, brought me to see my father, Victor Wolfie Kessel, perform in the ring at WrestleFest 1. I was super excited, like any kid, to see my father wrestle. He was, and still to this day, my hero. As I watched him fight, I knew right then and there, in that moment, I wanted to follow in his footsteps and become a world-class wrestler. Now here I am, 15 years later, standing in the same ring, ready to take on Mama T and Samantha Foxy. I can only hope he is proud of me today, as I was of him 15 years ago. This match is for you, Dad.
Yes, Leah, all you say is quite nice, but in all of that feels almost like you care about your dad being proud of you more than actually winning the SLCW Women's Championship belt. Don't get me wrong, it's all nice and sweet, but this is about our legacy, not about others being proud of us. And quite frankly, if you are of this idea, maybe you shouldn't be in this match in first place. If you have no ambition to put your name into the SLCW legacy and leave this to who really care about that. If by some chance... Leah, you really don't get it, aren't you? Your chances are that low to make look even Ruth Resident to have more chances than you to win, even if she have a complexity of over 900,000. And what about Mama T? Come on, Mama T. Come out.
Oh, now here come Mama T. Someone's going to get told pleasant. Someone's going to get told to mind their manners.
Know on the day I was born, the nurses
both
all gathered
y'all. Yeah, come on, old lady.
Hey, cut. No. First. Oh, no. Wait a second. Just for me, 100 precise about that. I hope at least for you, Mama T, you have a different attitude of Leah. Because I want to tell you something. I respect you. I like you, but I really saw tougher bikers than you, and hell, you make feel Sarah Jane Crowley like the goddess of all bikers, from Texas to New York and back.
I ain't worried about Sarah Jane Crowley, or you, or little Miss Moonburnt ass over in the corner. I'm here to reclaim what was mine, so shut up, show me what you got, and put 'em up.
Yes, Mama T, sure. And this is actually the time for the talking. And for what you say, and you keep saying for pretty much most of these weeks, you have really nothing to say, something threatening and such. But you're right about that. You're right. The time for the talking is done. And at WrestleFest 15, action will talk for us, and the winner will take all. So best of luck, and you both need it.
You're the ones that's gonna need it. I'm reclaiming what's mine.
Well, there you go. Leah Shelton, I don't need luck. I'm here, just here,
Kristen,
to get Mama off her high horse.
Mic to you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, look at that. Everyone should give Samantha a round of applause. She only wrestled the double return the microphone to the country team.